I am Santosh Gadkar. Today I am focusing on the control engineering. In control engineering, board plot. This is the problem in terms of quadratic equation. We have to find out the stability and K value. And K value for the 20 decibel for the gain margin. It is for gain margin. Gain margin. Okay, this is the formula. Question type 1. Step 1. G of S is equal to K of S. H of S is equal to K divided by S, S plus 10, S square plus 16 S is equal to into 1600. Now, make it common here. K divided by 10 as a common. S, S divided by 10 plus 1. 16 as a common, 1600. S square divided by 1600 plus 16 S divided by 1600. It becomes 1. Now multiply this one. K divided by 16 becomes 16,000. Yes, 1 plus 0.1 yes. Rewrite this one. Plus 1 plus. First you have to write this part. How to write this one? It's very important for us. Because we have to make in this form, quadratic equation form. How to write? First write this part. First, what is the root of 1600? It is 40. Plus, S divided by 40 whole square, you have to write. Then, you have to split this one in terms of 40 into 40. I will split 16S divided by 40 into 40. Whatever the value is there, you have to split in this form. If it is 60, you have to make this one as a 60 into 60. Based on the root. Based on the root here. Okay, now it is whole square. Whole square. It is very important part here. Very important part. Now, let k dash is equal to k divided by 16,000 is equal to k, nothing but 1. Is equal to 1 here. Now, 1 divided by s, 1 plus 0.1 s plus, sorry, into 1 plus 16 divided by 40 is nothing but 0.4. 0.4 S divided by 40 plus S divided by 40 whole square. Now replace S by step 2. Replace S by J omega. Now G J omega. H of S J omega. It can be written as 1 divided by J omega. 1 plus 0.1 j omega, 1 plus 0.4 j omega divided by 40 plus j omega divided by 40 whole square. Now what is j omega square? Is nothing but 1 minus 1. Now replace this one. 1 divided by j omega, 1 plus 0.1 j omega, 1 plus 0.4 omega by 40 j outside minus, because j omega square is minus, omega divided by 40 whole square. Now we have to bring in this form here. Now what is 2 zeta? 2 zeta is nothing but 0.4, where zeta is nothing but 0.2. Zeta is nothing but 0.2 as per this one, as per this formula. If you go for comparison, this is the formula. Now I will find the step 3, that is final control function or control, let control function upon control function factors CF radian per second. Now what are the factors you have to consider? First factor is constant K, 1. For 1, for constant, the Korner frequency will be nil. For constant, the Korner frequency will be nil. Right nil here. Next, j omega raised to minus 1. We are bringing upward. For that one, it is also nil. If you substitute in place of s, the Korner frequency will be nil. Next, this part, 1 plus 0.1 j omega raised to minus 1, where WTC is nothing but 1 by t, where 1 by t is nothing but 1 divided by 0.1, 10 radian per second. 10 per second. It is written here. Now we have brought in this way. Now next is quadratic equation. This plays an important role. 1 plus 0.4 omega divided by 40 j minus 40 divided by 4 omega divided by 40 whole square, where omega tc is nothing but what? Omega tc is nothing but wn. What is wn? Wn is nothing but 40. Whatever the value appears here, you have to write here. That's the important part. Whatever the value appears here, omega, this is omega n here. This value has to be written. This is omega n. This is omega n. This is the omega n. Where WCF is nothing but omega n. Write as a 40. If it is 20, write 20. 30, 30. The both value has to be same here. If the both value differs, the problem is down. If it is 30, this should be 30. If it is 50, this should be 50. Then only the problem will be correct. After completion of this field, rearrange it in order to create. Rearrange it. Now I have a rearrange it. Arrange it in increasing order. Increasing order. Now we have to arrange in the increasing order. First one is the factor 1. For factor 1, it is nil. For j omega raised to 1, it is nil. Now this one 10, and this is 40. 1 plus 0.1 j omega raised to 1 minus 1, 10. For this one, the slope will be as per the chart. Now this is the chart I'm referring. For constant, the slope will be 0 0, that will be 0. For j omega, it is 20, it is minus 20. Why? Means j omega is at the bottom, minus 20. 0 minus 20 is minus 20. Now this one is minus 20, this is also minus 20 slope, minus 20, minus 20, minus 40. Now this part plays an important role. First write this term, entire term you have to write it out. 1 plus 0.4 omega divided by 40 j minus omega divided by 40 whole square. Here, what you have to write? 40. The slope is 40. If it is entire thing is square, then 2 into 40. It is cube, 3 into 40. Now it is 40. Only you have to write 40. But, what is value here? Omega n is 40 here. The slope value is 40. Whether you have to do the positive 40 or negative 40, you have to take negative 40, because this term entirely lies below this line. Therefore, you have to write minus 40. Minus 40, minus 20, minus 20, minus 40 is nothing but minus 80. Minus 80. Now magnitude. How to now say the magnitude column now? For this one, 20 log 10 1. Next, for this one, minus 20 log 10 omega. Next, minus 20 log root 1 plus 0.1 omega whole square. For this one, this is the value you have to write. That is minus 40 log 10 omega divided by 40 in this form. Omega divided by Wn. Wn is nothing but 40. You have to write in this form. Why it is minus? Because it written it at the below this line. If it is above line, you have to take positive sign. Now face angle. Now for face, this is the face. This is the face column. For constant, face will be 0. For this one, it is 90, but it is minus 90 because it lies below here. Next, for this one, again, this is 90. Now here, again, this one is also 10 raised to minus tan inverse 0.1 omega divided by 1. For this one, this is the important part. How to write minus tan inverse? What is 2 zeta? 2 zeta will be 0.4 W by 40 divided by 1 minus W divided by 40 whole square. This part is very important. You have to write in this form. What is 2 zeta? 2 zeta is 0.4 omega divided by 40 1 minus omega divided by 40 whole square. 40 whole square, you have to write in this way. Okay, next you have to find out the magnitude. How to find out the magnitude of this one? Just add this one. Magnitude. Magnitude m is equal to 20 log 10 1 minus 20 log 10 omega minus 20 log root 1 plus 0.1 omega whole square minus 40 log 10 omega divided by 40. Omega divided by 40. I will make a column omega and magnitude. Magnitude. Now I will consider the magnitude as 0.1. In place of omega, substitute 0.1. You will obtain 124.08. Oh, this value is very high. Then I directly go for 1. Substitute the place of omega 1. You will obtain 64.03. Next, I will consider 10. In place of omega, you have to place the 10. It is 1.072. In place of omega 15, it is minus 11.60. Next, 50, it is minus 52. Minus 50. These are the values which are obtained here. Okay. Next, I will go for phi. Phi value. Phi is equal to minus 90 minus tan inverse 0.1 omega minus tan inverse 0.4 omega divided by 40 divided by 1 minus omega divided by 40 whole square. Now here omega and phase angle, that is phi. It is phi. Now I will consider the omega as 1. In place of omega, you have to substitute 1. Answer will be 96.28. Next, 8. I will directly consider 8. Sorry, 3, 3. I will consider 3. The minus 107. Next, I will consider 10. 141.08. For 20. 168.36. Up to 180 line. You have to cut the 180 line. Next, 25, for 1 this one, 2, for 10, for 20, for 25, 180.50, 30, 196, 35, 220. Now this completes the basic problem of this one. Okay, now based on this one I will draw the plot. This is the graph, Bode plot. This is the omega radian per second. Now it, I have taken omega 1 here because 0.1 is too big value, therefore I will start from 1. Omega 1, this is 10, this is 100, 1000, 10,000. Here zero line, we have drawn it. 180 line, we have drawn it here. Now, for 1, for omega is equal to 1, 64. Next, for 10, it is 1.0. Oh, sorry, at magnitude is equal to 1. Omega value will be 10. Magnitude is 1. Approximate here, 1. Magnitude is 1 here for 10. Next, 11, magnitude is 11.56 for 15. 15 is here or approximate here. Next, for 50, magnitude is 52 is here around here. It is 50. Now draw the line. Now GCF is around 1 point. You can consider the 1 GCF not the 1 year, 10.35, or exactly 10 radian per second, you can consider it, radian per second. Next, for this one, draw the line here. For 96, for omega is equal to 1, this is the 1 year, it is 96. Next, directly I will go for 10, because I know this is the 10, around 141 approximate here. Next, for 20, instead of 25, I will go 25. 25 will be approximate here for 80. Next, 96 and so on. No problem, you can draw it in this way. Click in this way. Now, this line has to be extended above in order to find out the GM value, and this point has to be extended below in order to find GM value. If you measure this value, the GM will be 28 minus 28. That means minus of minus 28, it will be 28 dB. Now if you measure this value, the PM will be 38 degree. You can write 38 degree, or you can write this one as a degree in terms of degree. No problem, you will get answer GM degree. This is radian per ton. Now PCF is nothing but what is the value for PCF? PCF will be around 25 radian per second. Both are falling in this, at the bottom the system is stable. One more. Now this can be done without graph directly. It is possible. I will show how to do that one. Now we know that the M value is going to cut at 0. Therefore, in place of M, I will substitute 0 here. 0, 20 log 10, 1, minus 20 log 10 omega, minus 20 log root 1 plus 0.1 omega square, minus 40 log 10 omega divided by 40. Now I will consider what is the value of omega. That's important here. What is value of omega? 20 log 1 minus 20 log alpha x minus 20 log root 1 plus 1 0.1 alpha x whole square, close the bracket, minus 40 log alpha x divided by 40. Alpha is equal to 0. Shift solve. You will get answer as approximate 28. It take a time in order to solve the problem. Now what is the GM value we got it? The GM value we got is 10. But if you do directly by making M as a 0, because it cuts the 0 line, the GCF will be 10.35 radian per second. This is the value we have obtained it. Now similarly, you can obtain by, in place of phi, you have to substitute minus 180. You can obtain the value of omega here in terms of phase. Now I will substitute here. Phi is equal to 180, minus 180 is equal to minus 90 minus tan inverse 0,1 omega minus tan inverse 0.4 omega divided by 40 divided by 1 minus omega divided by 40 whole square. Now you can directly obtain the value of omega by placing 180 here. Now I will place 180 minus 180. 180 shift is equal to minus 90 minus shift tan inverse 0.1 alpha x minus shift tan inverse, open the bracket, sorry, close the bracket, open it, 0.4 into alpha x divided by 40, close the bracket, bring at the bottom, 1 minus alpha, sorry, open the bracket, alpha x divided by 40 whole square, close the bracket, shift solve, you would get the answer as 25, around 25 you will get, directly will get. Now the answer is 24.80, obtained value is 25. It can be obtained directly without any graph. Now PCF is nothing but 24.80 radian per second. Either you can go for graphically or this one, but in exam, because it graph carries the weightage, therefore refer the graph. Otherwise, for the cross check, you can use this one. Now you got the GF value and PCF value. You can obtain the GM value and PCF value. How? Now whatever the GF value obtained, whatever the value is you obtained, it substitute in the place of omega and make this one as a, it should be eliminated. Now in this way you have to do it. Minus 90 minus tan inverse 0.1 omega, in place of omega you have to substitute 10.35 minus tan inverse 0.4 10.35 divided by 40 divided by 1 minus 10.35 divided by 40 whole square. You will obtain the answer, we will, whatever the answer it is obtained is minus 142.31 you will obtain. Now because we are comparing from the 180, now just from 180 what is the difference, that means plus 180 you can do it, you will obtain the value as 37.684, because we have to measure the difference. We got this value, this value is 142.31, you have to measure this one, this is nothing but PM. If you measure it, you will obtain 37.80. And similarly, if you substitute this value to 24.80 in place of omega, you will obtain, in this way you have to do it, 20 log 101 minus 20 log 10 24.80 minus 20 log root 1 plus 0.1 20 into 24.08 whole square minus 40 log 10 24.80 divided by 40. If you calculate, the answer will be obtained for this one is minus 28.12, and you have to write minus of minus, it will be 28.12. Both are positive, the system will be stable. Directly you can obtain it. One more graph is there. Either you can go for the graphical method, or you can go for the analytical method, or one more type is there, that is we call as a direct type. How to obtain the direct type? Or, it is also or. Either you can go for that method, or this method. In this method, here this part plays an important role. Now for constant, we should leave this constant. Now for 20 log 10 is nothing but 0. If you substitute to 20 log 10 is nothing but 0. This is the line we are considering it. Now for this one, you have to write in this way. For 0 to 10, 0 to 10, this value you have to consider. Minus 20. Next to 10 to 40. Minus 40. Next 40 to infinite 80. You have to consider this 80. You have to write in this way. Now first draw the lines in this way. From the 20, take as a 1 as a common. Draw a dotted line here in this way. From 20, from 40, from 60, from 80. This is the dotted line we have drawn. After drawing the dotted line, how to draw now? Now, from 0 to 10 is 20. 20 is nothing but this is the line. If it is a positive 20, we have to consider as a minus 20 here. 20. From 0 to 10, it is 20. Because this is the 10, draw a line. This is 20. Next, 10 to 40. 10 to 40. That means 40 is here. It is minus 40. Minus 40 means this line you have to consider. Up to 40 you have to draw the line. Up to 40 you have to draw the line. Next, after reaching the 40, 40 to infinity is 80. 80 line means this is the 80 line. You have to hold the parallel and move it. 40 to infinite. It is 80 line. In this way you can solve it. The bottom will be remain same. The bottom point will be remain same as it is. This is the one of the procedure to follow it by using in this way. Okay, now I will consider this similarly. This point, roughly I am doing it here because already I have done this one. 25. We'll obtain the same graph. If you measure the values, we'll obtain the GM as minus 28, that is 28 degree. If you measure here, PM will be 38 and GCF is nothing but 10 radian per second, and PCF is nothing but 25 radian per second. Either you can solve this method, or analytical method. Each and every method gives the same answer. Now both falling, this fall below and this fall above, the system is stable. System is stable. Any one method you can follow it. It is up to you. I am Santosh Gadankar. Thank you very much.